Operational report. Our submarines are detected. Repairs complete. Spotting reports from the Vengeance and the B-25s, but no attacks. Recon over Langkawi, Tanjung Pinang, Chichijima, and Hiroshima. More recon, more contact reports. Submarine under attack, but not hit. We hit a SSX 5084. Now, where is that? Could that be Singapore? We'll have to check that. But it's a Vengeance dive bomber that hit it, so it had to be over there, right? Somewhere. The Suzuki hit, supposedly. I think we hit it twice already. Contact report, more recon. Reinforcements taken. Look at all those bases. We started the Chinese base expansion at the same time. So there, now we're reaping the benefits. These were all done at the same time. Refit begins. Upgrades. Repairs complete, and they return. Reinforcement at Portland, Alameda, and these are the Dutch fighters, Dutch aircraft arriving at Abadan. No submarines ready on Hong Kong, all in refit. We have one submarine in Shanghai, but she is bad. Well, she's been hit significantly. 8% is not a death sentence, but it should be fixed. Oh, what else is here? We have the Whale is in. It's critical. Okay, put her in the shipyard. And these others are normal refit. Over on the Korean Peninsula, I'm getting a little pissed here. That's at least 2 days, maybe even three, that these guys just refuse to freaking launch. The spy boys are putting their lives on. Oh, we lost one. What happened to it? Well, he wasn't even flying recon and we lost him? Anyway. We'll have to get another pilot. Set all the recon for this. We're gonna keep flying it. What the hell? Why aren't they getting in the air? Get a veteran. Look at all those we got hundreds of recon pilots. Not all great experience, but at least lots and lots and lots of them. We've trained so many, but not up to any really high level. So these guys keep flying, and these cowards. I don't know. Are we? I know it's where the base administration is too many. Could it be that I have too many trying to fly from the base? Could be. But it did fly once. We know it flew once. Is that it? Is that all we're allowed to do? Fly once? Okay. What we're going to do is try to reduce it. We'll take down the 17 Foxes and the 17 Echoes. We'll see if the Liberators can fly by themselves. Maybe if we put less stress on the number of groups, maybe now they'll get in the air. We have an air headquarters here, but it is China Command. So this, I don't know all the rules. I'm not certain of all the rules. They may not be able to help these U.S. Army commands. But still, we have a U.S. Army headquarters here. General Tinker, he's the top of the class, top of the chart for commanders. Maybe he can help. More construction companies have arrived along with air aviation support. So we've got plenty of aviation support now. Yeah, all throughout the area. We just need to build the damn bases. More are still coming. Great. Okay. I'm going to order, let's try. We're going to try with these Mitchells. We're going to try for bombing. Let's go naval. Ground attack secondary. Let's try for Tsushima. Why? Yeah, it's close. And I better. The escort, the bow fighters. Okay, we better pull them down. All bow fighter fives. We'll go to a range of two. Try if they. If the enemy tries to interfere, we'll try to hold them back. I'm not putting very much. I'm thinking the enemy should not be able to see us. We should be in and out before he can even react, even if he has radar here. I'm hoping that at least. So let's see how that works. Remember, I'm trying to use both of these so that we can try to increase the go naval and then secondary ground. That way, I'm hoping we can get more experience increase more quickly. In Korea, we have a lot of base forces in Chinhae. Another group is arriving, more heading for Fusan, trying to build that baby up. Okay, we wiped out the border fortress here. We're now marching up, try to clear this one, get the rail line open for us. I've ordered the headquarters unit. I'm going to try to march some of these headquarters. I'm going to test. I'm going to try to march headquarters into Russia, in Soviet Union. If I can get them in here, maybe I can help these. Maybe I can rally the comrades and get them to march out into here, or get them. Maybe the AI will bomb us, or I'm going to try getting some Chinese and some of the English, the British headquarters. They're not doing much anyway. Into Soviet Union and see if we can't get them into the war. I doubt it, but hey, it never hurts to try. We have wiped out a few more units at Kiamush through attrition. There's only one left, so I'm going to continue the attack. We're just going to exterminate the last one. Now we're going to move down towards Fuchin. I'll try to get a unit across the river. We cannot march from here because this is an enemy base. If we try to march down here, all we do is turn around and come back out this way anyway. So that's a real pain. Well, we're not doing much over here regardless, so we may as well come marching back out. So I think this turn, even though we're low on supply, we're still getting a minimal, almost non-existent 20. We don't have as many as we need, but doesn't mean we're out of supply. We just don't have as many as these guys are operating on half rations. Still, that should be enough to destroy one pissant little machine aircraft, whatever leftover. Up here, we're attacking. Yeah, we're gonna attack. Hey ho, we captured it. We've sent two road construction battalions up the road. So now we're gonna have to go up here and make sure we surround them before destroying this fortress and the two companies, the two battalions. As I've always said, no matter what happens, the AI always finds a way to squirt out of here. Always. So I could be just chasing these guys all around the forever. If you don't cut them off, surround them, and then destroy them. We are at Hailar. I'm just going to go into shock. There's two units here. There's a fortress, a fixed fortress, probably something like the ones down here, and an auto machine gun company that's more like an anti-aircraft company, I believe. My little guy here got just bashed to hell trying to attack. They got bigger guns than us, so I'm going into shock. There's 4,000 here. That's got to be enough. All I want to do is I want to kill that auto machine company. The fortress isn't going anywhere. It cannot squirt loose, so I don't have to worry about chasing that one. But if I can shock it and hit it hard enough, maybe I can destroy that auto machine gun company rather than chasing them all through the back and beyond. Reinforcements come up the railway or coastal way from Langson. The enemy bombed us and we're still marching. It's nice. I think in the previous versions of the games, when if units were on rail and moving, I think they could be bombed off the rail. They would drop into combat mode and stop moving and not be able to get back on the train, and it was a real nightmare. So I don't know if it's been like this. It was like this in the original game, but maybe it's been like this since the beginning of AE. But that's nice that they don't change modes, that we continue to march. Okay, everything. I've got a whole bunch of units. Got 483 assault value here on Kamron Bay. I'm thinking, well, geez, what do I want to do with these guys? Well, you know, we're heading up here already. I think we're going to take out Haifong as we pass. These guys, so we're going to change. We're going to stop off at Hanoi and then march into Haifong. Set all to march. Yeah, some of these units are going to withdraw within a few months, and some of these units, like the Patiala, cannot even leave the continent. See, they're restricted as well. So burn them up, use them up. I've got a lot of guns here. I don't know how useful guns are against a fortress assault, but well, we're in no rush to get these off. We don't have the political points to buy them out either. All right, now watch this. Here's my two. These were the guys that were fixing up Sok Trang, and now I sent them over to Lang Son, and they're going up the back road, the Ho Chi Minh Trail. How can that be considered intelligent? For God's sakes! Stop, idiots! Okay, so we're gonna set them back down to Kamran Bay. Set all to march, and then we'll get back out onto the railroad and head for Lang Son. These guys are headed for Saigon. Okay, they've come around the back roads and are coming into Saigon. I will order them into Cameron as well. Set all to march. Hopefully they'll arrive next turn. These guys, should I be using them on there's 3,000. Do I need 3,000 assault to break down Haifong? Is what it comes down to. Is that the level I need? Well, I'm not in a real, as stated, I'm not in a real rush to get over to Korea, other than using these guys as engineers. I better make sure these guys are all going to the southeast. Yeah, nobody's going up. Okay. I might just send the tanks along. That might be the fastest. But we're going to meet up in Hanoi and then decide how many are going to go south to Haifong. Phnom Penh, no others. These others are still coming in to Saigon. What's these guys? Oh, this AA regiment. Yeah. Slowly but surely inching its way through the woods rather than taking the railroad. Quiet day in Malay. Nothing much happening. The bombers are out. Maybe they'll hit a few cutters, whatnot. Submarines are on the patrols. Nobody else coming in or out. No air attack. That was kind of interesting. Is it the weather? Well, we've got bad weather on a couple on Alora Star, but Kota Baru and Singora are open. Victoria Point, it's been like this for quite a while. So it looks like the headquarters is insufficient to actually repair Victoria Point. It's too badly damaged, where it's going to take a long time to repair. Convoys arriving in Rangoon, no problem. I'm hoping we're helping the supply situation by bringing it forward rather than pushing it through the forest. I don't know for certain, but I'm hoping. Why is this going to Akyab? Return to Chittagong. Yeah, that's fine. At Chuebo, we have another Kowloon Brigade has arrived. So he'll follow, set all to march. Follow where X Force is going. Another base force has arrived at Impal. Reinforcement. Okay. Get off the train. March down to Chuebo. Like everybody else. The Chittagong is still very restricted in supply. That's fine, guys. We planned on it. We asked for it. Where's the damn supply? All the ships are waiting for it. At least it's quiet. No enemy activity. Convoy of tenders on final approach to Ceylon. Landing ships trying to move past. We're okay. Nothing happening in Bombay. No ships coming in. out. Oh, are they coming in? They are coming in with the East African division. All right, these guys are moving at 14 knots. We can wait one turn before coming out to meet them with escorts. Nothing happening in Karachi, just convoys in and out, nothing special. Actually, there's a minor arrival here, another base force, RAF base force. Turn on the replacements, upgrade. Oh, this was another one. Yep, we can send it. Kobe. We're not going to Kobe right away. It's just one of those things to remind ourselves that we're heading for Kobe. Sending it down to Impal, marching it. What am I doing? Strategic. March down to Impal. And in on to China. Oh, another convoy. What the heck is this? Oh, this is the long range one, right? Right, another landing ship, see? LSL, landing ship infantry large, making its way across to Hobart. No reinforcements, South Africa. Submarine check. Uh-oh, Albacore's been hit. I didn't see that in the reports. I just missed it, probably. Great, thank you for the button. Heading back, plenty of fuel, plenty of time. Tuna, I think we already called it back. Yes, no other ships, no other damage, no. Checking endurance, S-38. Ooh, we better call her back, call her home. By clicking four or five times, yes! Every damn one. Grayling is already due back, and Snapper needs to come back. There we go. Torpedo check. Submarines Shad and Snook fired off a couple of torpedoes, but they still have weapons and are good to go. Albacore fired off a couple. Ah, she earned it. Time for some R&R. Timor's gone quiet, but we still have our bases. An enemy minesweeping group moving around the back, so, well, they're taking no action on us. So we'll leave them alone, too. We're going to start moving these P-38 Foxes up. They've been resting here. Time to see how far can we transfer these guys. Well, we'll start shifting them up, heading for Korea. We had a couple great little... Let's see, which of these encounters? Not this one, looks like. Well, this one. Wayala, engaged with her depth charges. There's no upgrade for these guys, so they don't get mousetrap. Well, they're doing the best they can. The weapons are just too light to actually kill the damn submarine. We've got 11 hits on it, and you know what? It'll probably escape, which is darn shame. Darn shame. We have a number of ships that just came out of refit here, but none of them are the sub-chasers of the... So then none of these got any new weapons with which to kill the enemy. So I'm wondering if maybe this is... Well, it doesn't hurt to practice, but maybe I'm risking minesweepers for no real advantage. The submarines were getting through them anyway with the occasional attack, but now we're actually taking efforts to sink them. The retrieval convoy is now set sail. We will refuel when we get there. Here's the replenishment convoy returning. Let's see about Maryborough. Nope, Medusa is still stuck. Over in New Zealand, the transport is heading up to Auckland for embarkation. Let's make sure that this is ready to go. Yes, he's on strategic, ready to go. Over in Palmyra, we've successfully evacuated most of the force. We're leaving the Fanning Island Detachment because it has a couple of aviation support squads on here. That's good. As I've shown previously, the vital importance of the naval support squads really, really, really help the unloading. So we're going to get these over to Saipan for embarkation to Japan. Nothing happening in Panama. Pearl Harbor. I was waiting. I think I said that I was waiting for the carrier to come out, right? I was. But she never came out. Oh, man. Yeah. Well, we'll get it done. So I put it up. I boosted it up to critical. Let's just get it out of here. The cruiser, Australia, has come in for her upgrade. The Trenton, I think I was saving Trenton for the Dutch destroyers as a destroyer leader to help cover Ponape. There's not much over here, but this is a kind of a just-in-case battle. That's why I leave the Dutch down there. The destroyers here, and we'll wait for the escort carrier to come out, and then we'll take her back to Guam. Over on the west coast, we have no ships ready here. None! So no wonder the supply jumped up to 650,000. Nobody's taking it. Right. But we do have a new reinforcement at Portland, so we'll start up the Josiah Snelling. It's a port level 7, but jeez! Let's see, is there any support here? You know, I could start loading here, and this would still take for freaking ever, I suspect. Okay, we'll load supplies. And I'll set it off for Guam. Oops. Let's see. Heading outwards. Let's try that. Kind of never sailed from this location before, so kind of a mishmash. Yeah, they'll just go out and meet up with the Vancouver stream, I guess. We do have an air unit here, and these are, it's an interesting little unit. More, it's a float plane. Is that a Sea Mew? Never. The first time I've heard of it until I started playing this game. Unfortunately, the aircraft's only available 1 month. Oh, freaking. Or maybe two. Okay, 6th and 7th. No? Well, does that mean it's 2 months? It shows up on the 6th and leaves on the 7th? So maybe 2 months. 2 months. That's not a hell of a lot of aircraft. It's actually a pretty good aircraft. It's got a normal range of 7. I'd be tempted to put this into operational use because it has a pretty good search range, and there's large numbers, but I don't know how many of the damn things I get. There's two spares right now, and I don't want to use them up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to order this one to train just more fighter pilots. Just train more fighter pilots. We'll go low and down. We have two pilots already here, and they're already, I would consider, qualified for bombing. But I'm going to take these guys out if I can. Of course I cannot. No, game will not let me. So that means I'm going to have to grab a bunch of... Oh, let's see. Yeah, I could grab some other pilots and retrain or train them more better so that they would have higher skills. Maybe I'll go... Let's take a look at the fighter stream. See, these pilots down here, they don't have a lot of experience, but they're qualified. They're 57, they're experience-wise. So they need to fly combat missions in order to get the experience up higher. There's nothing that our training here can do for them. We have... There's like 800. Gosh, there's already 800. But What needs training? Bomber pilots. I don't need those. Search planes. We've got patrol pilots. We have in the hundreds. Another good 1,000 there. So I don't really know. Oh, okay. We'll train a recon. That's what we'll do. We'll train some recon pilots. And we'll just grab raw recruits. Now we have our experienced pilots. These are the naval bombers. Let's retire these guys. Pure recon. That'll do it. We'll send them over to Los Angeles, where all the other ones are waiting and training. Anything else up here? There are tankers. Yep. See, that's what happens in a big base. These guys would already be gone. But in a slightly smaller base like Vancouver, without much naval support, they take an extra day. On Guam, it's an embarrassment of riches. Our two convoys, fuel convoys, still have 100,000, 110,000 to unload, and we've already got another one inbound. How much is here? Is it this one? Yes, this one. With 140,000 more fuel points. Just can't get them off can't get them off quickly enough. Well, that'll put us over 100. That should put us over a million. And I don't know what to do with the other. Send them. Where do we stockpile it? You know how long it takes to use up a million points of fuel here? We'll never get it unloaded. I think I'll just start sending them to Australia. At least Australia, you can stockpile it. I don't know. They're not going to use it up either. So I'll probably go one convoy, Guam, one convoy, Australia. One convoy, Guam, one convoy, Australia. That'll send them out. Nothing else here. Carriers are just waiting. Just waiting. The replenishment ships have refueled. Load the tenders. The tenders, the AOs are finishing, are fueling. We hit the sub. Not enough to kill it, but we hit it. Now we've got groups around here. I'm hoping that we can finish her off. Already we're prepped. Got the... Selected the ones for EWO and the ones... Oops. All the combat troops are in combat mode. But the engineers and the secondary troops, we've broken them up according to where they're landing. Chichijima, Iwo Jima. Put them in strategic. So these guys will come in with the second and third waves once the base has been secure. In the Bonin Islands, I've got carriers are sitting on top. We're still loading the San Lucas, the AKE, but the carriers are sitting on top. I pushed one of them into the port in order to pump a little bit, pump dry and any other damaged ships. But we've dropped them in here. The bombardment groups, two bombardment groups, the damaged Maryland and Tennessee are still active. I'm sending them against a short range. But the other ones are going, the fresher ones, are going after Iwo Jima. Keep it suppressed. The carriers have told the battleships, you guys want protection? Get over here. We've got three air groups, but you have to get back to Hajima in time. So let's see if this works. S-47 evades a patrol boat. Air raid, Hajima. 12 Bettys are intercepted. Bombardment, Iwo Jima. Great, still hitting them on the ground. Okay, better than nothing. Chichijima, bomber, bombed. Hitting ground units, good. Where's my air raid? Oh, for God! Hiroshima failed again, huh? You're going in the daylight next time. You cowards! That's the only way to get them to fly. I don't know. We'll keep trying. Tenosa decides not to fire. Another coward. Lapin fires and hits a loaded transport. She's a goner. S-30 fires at an E-boat. Miss. Trusty evades. Didn't we bomb that one? I thought we bombed that one. I-172 hit four more times with depth charges, but these are light depth charges. Barely scratching the paint. Air attack. Oh, a divided, or what would you call that? Separated? Oh, well. A dispersed 39th Chinese Corps is bombed. No hits. On an offside note, there's a Subchaser 28 is reportedly hit by a Catalina or some kind of patrol plane, and patrol corvette Ashi is also hit. Well, and there's maybe more, but you can't scroll up to it. A Lower Star bombed in the afternoon. We put a 80-90 aircraft up against 27. We get four, but we lose another hurricane. Air attack on the Hajima, the battleships. Okay, nine Bettys. This time they're stopped cold. Yeah, that's what I want to see. Look at those Wildcats. Eat them up. Bombing practice, Jellowit. Tanjung Pinang bombed. One of the squads disabled. Good. Bombed again. Another squad disabled. Well, we'll get to them. Slowly but surely. Missed. Nakhon Ratchasima, practice bombing. The B-25s bomb. Miss. Nakhon Ratchasima, more practice. Cameron Bay bombed as we pass through. Oh, woohoo! On the train, they hit it. They hit it. How do they find something like that in motion? Oh, well. Well, if you just saw that, there was a claim of a midget submarine attacked by a Vengeance dive bomber. One hit should be enough to get rid of those things. Shock attack, Hailar! Captured! No flights. Oh, we actually destroyed 21 aircraft. Let's see, units two destroyed! Yes! Annihilated! But we took some heavy casualties too. That's all right. Always more Chinese where they came from, right? Why are Chinese so... why are there so many Chinese people in the world, and why are they so good at math? Because Chinese people know how to multiply. All right. 806, 806 to 1, ground combat at Kiamus. I think we should be... Oh, man, he's still there! What the hell is it? Disable a couple of ours. It's the Air Force Battalion. Air Force pukes. Deliberate attack, hey-ho. 73 to 1. Trying to destroy that fortress. Nope, no luck. And he kills one of my squads. A good round of combat. Oh, here it is. 6th Border Defense Forces wiped out. Okay, so we, even though we didn't destroy them with a deliberate attack, it's wiped out by attrition. Expansions and fortifications increase.